Let us discuss the first question of exercise 5.2. This is from chapter Understanding Elementary Shapes from NCERT Mathematics for class 6. The first question is, what fraction of the clockwise revolution does the hour hand of the clock turn? If it points to 3 and then it moves to 9. What is the question? Let us first draw a clock. Mark the numbers. This is 3. Here you have 6. Here you have 9. So here you have 1, 2, this is 4, this is 5, 7, 8, 10 and 11. You can draw the clock in any shape. Correct? Now, the question is about the fraction of the hour hand when it turns from 3 to 9. This is 3 and this is 9. So draw a line now. This is 0.9, okay? So this is 3 to 9. In which direction? In clockwise direction. It is given that it is in clockwise direction. So the hour hand, if it turns from 3 to 9, what will be the fraction? So clockwise direction means you will draw the arrow showing that it is moving in clockwise direction. Here also I can show inside, see, clockwise direction. So let me write down, what do you mean by a fraction? Fraction means part of a whole. So on whole, let us find out how many parts are selected. See, it started from, it is where it is, it is pointing at 3. So let us count the numbers. It will point after 3. It is already at 3. So the first time from 3, the hour hand will point 4. Let me write down first. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. It is already at 3. So how it will turn in clockwise direction? It will first go to 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8 and then it will reach 9. So how many parts got selected, or at how many points, or at how many numbers the hour hand has pointed? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many parts got selected? 6. On a whole. So on a whole, how many numbers you have on a clock? 12. Count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You will say, ma'am, you are counting from 1. This is very simple, you know. If I start from here, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and I have reached 12. Okay? So it is 12. What is the fraction? 6 by 12. Now further, if you can reduce, you will reduce. So below this, I will write here. After this, you will write down 6 ones are, 6 twos are. So what is the fraction? 1 by 2 is the fraction when the hour hand moves from 3 to 9 in clockwise direction. So this is your first question, first part solution. Copy the solution. Do write down this at the rough hand side. Okay, you will know how you got 6. So copy the solution, children. Okay, now let us see the second part. It is given in the same question that if the hour hand starts from 4 and moves to 9, now tell what will be the fraction and if it is moving in clockwise direction. So now the hour hand is pointing at 4. Where is 4? Here. So join this, make a line. Okay. Where it has to go and it will stop at 7. Where is 7? Here. So 4, it is already at 4. It will go to 5, 6 and only then it will reach 7. So it is at 4. So the first time when the clock hand will move from 4, it will point to 5, then to 6, then to 7. So how many houses or how many numbers it has moved? So selection here is how many parts of the numbers it has got selected, or got pointed at three numbers, 1, 2, and 3 numbers. What they are asking? They are asking you to find out what is the fraction of the hour hand if it moves from clockwise direction from 4 to 7. And what do we mean by fraction? Part of whole. So how many parts got selected this time? This time we got 3 parts. So whole, on whole, how many numbers you have on the clock? We always have 12 numbers. So 3 by 12. Now you can simplify it. So this will become, this simplification also, try to reduce it or simplify it using pencil. 3 ones are 3, 3 fours are 12. So what is the fraction? 1/4 is the fraction when the minute hand moves from, turns from 4 to 7 in clockwise direction. In the same question, if it was given that it is moving in anti-clockwise direction, so what will you do? First, you copy the solution, show this clockwise direction. I will show from here also. Okay, do show the clockwise direction. Otherwise, your solution will be wrong. How you got 3? Because if you take it by anti-clockwise direction, the answer, the selection of the numbers or the hour hand pointing will not be at 3 numbers. It may be different for anti-clockwise. That I will discuss with you. First, you copy the solution. Write down this and copy the solution. Okay, now let us discuss the same question. But if the hour hand is at 4 and it turns through 7, but in anti-clockwise direction. So see, from 4, it is at 4, correct? So the first time clock hand from 4 will go to 5 or 3. If, see, it is at 4. If it goes to 5, it means clockwise direction. And anti-clockwise is like this. So this time after 4, the hour hand will point at 3. Let me write down. So it is at 4. Now it will point 3. Then it will be 2. Then 1. Then 12. Then 11. Then 10. Then 9. 8. And then finally it will reach hour hand at 7. So it is at 4. So now count from here at which numbers the hour hand has pointed and reached number 7. See, 10, 9, 8, 7. Count. It was at 4. So it will start from the next numbers. Yeah, because see, this number we will not count. So it will start from 3. This will be my first selection, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and 9. So how many parts you have seen here? It got selected, or the hour hand has pointed to how many hour hands? These many. That is 9 upon 12. So 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12. In that case, it will be 4 to 7. But if the case is of anti-clockwise, then you will see the revolution will be 3/4 of the fraction. Okay, so you can copy this solution also. Change the question, 4 to 7 in anti-clockwise direction. Copy the solution. Now see the E part of the first question. Now they are saying if the hour hand is at 1 and then it turns through 10 in clockwise direction. Now you tell what will be the fraction of revolution. So let us start. Where is 1? Here. It will start from 1. Point at 1. So it will start from 1 hour hand. Correct? Now where we want to go? It will turn to 10. We want to reach 10 in clockwise direction. So this time the direction will be clockwise. Correct? Now see, in one revolution, when it starts from 1 in clockwise direction, the first number to which it is going to point is at 2. Then it will point to 3. Then 4. Then 5. Then 6. Then 7. 7, then 8, 9, and finally it will reach 10. So now see, what is the fraction of revolution? We know fraction is the selected part what you take on the whole of that selection. So here on whole we know clock has 12 numbers. So we will take 12. Now how many numbers got selected? The hour hand has pointed first time moving through clockwise direction. It pointed to 2, then it pointed to 3, then to 4, then 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9, and finally it has reached 10. So see the selections, count the number. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What is the answer? 9 numbers got selected. So what is the fraction? 9 by 12. Now take out your pencil and simplify. 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12. So 3/4 of the revolution is taken place when the hour hand was at 1 and went through 10 in clockwise direction. So this is the solution for your E part. Same way you have two more, please try to do it on your own. So that will be your homework.